Martin, great to see you. First of all, how's it going? And update us with everything you've had to go through off the pitch.
Oh, it's going good. It was a bit slow in the beginning, but I'm kicking on now and I'm ahead of schedule. So I'm walking properly now and I'm jogging a bit slow on the treadmill. So it's going well.
It's a frustrating time for any player, I know, when they're out with injury, but just talk us through your recovery and the sort of things you've got to go through to come back from an injury like the one you sustained.
Yeah, so the injury, it's about 6 months for the rehab. First probably 8-10 weeks, I can't really do a lot, so I was just resting and just taking it easy, really. But it's now recently I've been able to do my leg workouts and some calf raises, so it takes a bit of time, but I think now I'm in a good month where I can work hard.
You were such a big part of Swansea's season this campaign under Graham Potter, 17 appearances, and then that moment back in December against Brentford, which we won 3-2, but it was season changing for you. Just talk us through that moment, if you can recall it, and what went through your mind at the time.
Yeah, so first of all, I think I came back and I missed my pre-season, but I think after like 2 to 3 games, I started coming back and I felt strong. I felt I was playing good, even in the national team as well. And then I remember it was a few games I was on the bench here, and then I got my start against Brentford. And to be honest, I felt a bit in the warm-up, like a little bit, not a sharp pain, but I felt it. Discomfort, but it went over after like 10 seconds, so I kept on, I made some sprints and I tried to run it off and it worked, didn't feel anything. And then about 7 minutes into the game, less than 10 minutes, I passed the ball, and as soon as I just took a step, so I didn't run, I just took a step to like walk away, then I just heard like a big snap. So first I thought it was a ball boy or something, that I kicked that ball onto my Achilles, so I turned around, looked around and see no one there, and then the pain came, and then I knew straight away what I did, because Leroy and Nathan, they told me how that feeling was as well prior to like a few months back. So I'd say after like a couple of seconds there, I knew what I'd done, and it's pretty painful.
What goes through you? I mean, obviously the pain, as you just said, but what goes through your mind at the time? You said you knew what had happened, but did you know how serious it could have been for you for the season?
Yeah, I was thinking, you think a lot during that period when it happened, but it was more like, I mean, I just got back into the team as well. I had small niggles before, but I felt good. And I was playing well as when I had the chance, so. And I thought we was in a good position as well to kick on. So it's a lot of things, a lot of frustration, but then it's a part of the football as well. It's a part of the game, and you know the positives I have to see with it is I can rest my body fully now and come back a lot stronger.
How tough is it to watch from the sidelines this season? A lot of coming back from injuries, these the mental side of things as well as the physical side of things. Has it been tough to watch the Swans this calendar year?
Yeah, I'd say the first 10 weeks really, I couldn't go to the games or watch it, I was mostly at home, but after that, when I've been watching the games and I see we're starting to play well and play to our potential, you know, I want to be on the pitch as well and I want to help up the team, but I'll just take my time and, you know, I just need to come back stronger mentally, I've been thinking a bit about it, but not too much.
You had the chance as well to get away from Wales and get, you know, have a bit of time out. Did that help clear your mind to that trip to America and to see family and friends?
Yeah, I needed that. I went somewhere away with the missus first, and then a few weeks later I went to America to see my family. So I needed that. The physios, they took good care of me and they said I need to get away, you know, to relax mentally. And I feel that has helped as well because I'm working harder now. And I'm in a better place mentally as well. So I'm just looking forward now. And to be honest, I've really not forgotten, but I'm not thinking about what happened a few months back. I'm just focused on getting my calf stronger and I'm getting better for every week.
And as you say, you've been back working hard here the last few weeks. So what have you made of the Swans and the way the youngsters in particular have been playing? Certainly that impressive performance against Manchester City most recently.
No, it's good to see, because all of us, the more experienced players, we've seen the potential in trainers the whole season, and for them to do it against a team like Man City, we're just happy to see that as well. And it just shows the potential we have, that if we do keep a good consistency in the Championship, we can pick up a lot of points the way we just showed against Man City. So we showed some good potential there.
From this moment, what does the next few weeks look like for you? Do you hope to play some part again this season?
Probably only like if we'd go in the playoffs, and far in the playoffs, maybe I'd even try to give it a go then, but otherwise maybe it'd be a bit too early, I think. But we'll see, I'll just take it, you know, day by day. And if I feel good earlier, I'll come back, of course, quicker. But if I have to take a bit of time, I'll just take my time.
And do you set yourself targets at all? I know you kind of said that maybe end of April you were looking to be back on the grass. And that is that a set target for you, or do you just take it day by day as the coaches, the physios work with you?
Yeah, so we set that target probably after a month into my rehab. And the target was end of April, beginning of May, I go out on the pitch. But then we said after that, you know what, we'll just take it day by day. And if I feel good, I'll go out when I feel well, and if not, I'll just take my time. So not really a target right now, but I'm aiming for something around that period.
And whenever it is, you must be just keen, itching to get back playing again and you know, having the ball at your feet.
Yeah, I miss playing. I miss running with the ball and, you know, just playing some good football and enjoying my football. So it's frustrating, but you know, I think it's in a good way as well, because I'm feeling hungry. I'm feeling like I want to go out on the pitch, and I wouldn't even play better than I did before. So I'm hungry for more when I get back.
And unfortunately for us, we've had a few Swans out with a few niggly or long-term injuries. We spoke to Joe Roden recently. He said that the likes of yourself and Leroy had really helped him stay focused in the gym. It's, you know, got some good laughter, some good banter between you guys. Just give us that sort of like flavour, that sort of reflection of what it is like when you do have a few of you out working hard behind the scenes and just trying to come back fitter and stronger.
Yeah, it's always, of course, not good to have someone else in the treatment room, but we had a good group there, me, Leroy and Joe, and we all pushed each other. When you see maybe Joe was having a tough time one day, we'd push him on to work harder. Same with me, with Leroy, so we had a good group there, and we pushed each other. So I'm just happy that Joe is back and he can enjoy his football. So it's just me and Leroy left. So hopefully no one else will come in and join me. So
yeah, definitely kind of like a band of brothers, I guess.
Exactly. Yeah. No, you get a different bond as well when you're out for that long together. So we had a good time in there, but we worked hard as well. And yeah, just shows how fit Joe is right now as well, and you can see when he's coming back, he's gonna come back even stronger.